I'm Tom Doyle, one of the founding faculty of the Center for Law and Society here at the Community College of Philadelphia. Welcome to CCP TV, Community College of Philadelphia's educational TV channel. Today's perspective series focuses on issues of concern to many people in society today, maintaining health care after a job loss. The presentation will be given by Steve Ludwig, a partner with Fox Rothschild, whose practice specializes in a full array of labor and employment matters. Steve earned his bachelor's degree from the University of Pennsylvania Wharton School and his law degree from the University of Pennsylvania Law School. He has served as a board member and secretary for the Women's Law Project, as president of the Shannon Village Condominium Association, and as president of the Board of Family Support Services, Incorporated. He has also lectured at numerous continuing legal education seminars for lawyers and has been selected as a super lawyer by Philadelphia Magazine and Law and Politics Magazine. Steve is also a member of the advisory board of the Paralegal Studies Program here at Community College of Philadelphia. We are very fortunate to have Steve with us today as he provides us with valuable information on an issue that is of critical concern to many in today's struggling economic conditions.
My name is Steve Ludwig. I'm an attorney with Fox Rothschild. Fox Rothschild is a national law firm which started in our fair city. And I'm a labor and employment lawyer, and I want to talk with you today about an important topic: how to keep your group health benefits after a layoff. There are two new laws which are important because they may enable you to keep health benefits at a time when someone or someone's family is economically challenged. So I want to explain these two laws to you today and discuss whether you may be eligible to maintain these important benefits. Before I do that, of course, I have my own lawyer, and they've asked me to tell you that I'm not providing you with formal legal advice. I am not your own personal lawyer, but I will explain these laws to you, and I will provide you with information at the end of the program where you can obtain more information from certain governmental agencies that are there to provide you with additional information, can answer questions, and can assist you if you have problem receiving these important benefits. The first law is what's known as the stimulus law, or commonly known as the stimulus law. Its formal name is the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act of 2009. And this is a law which provides for billions of dollars in benefits, infrastructure improvements, and the like. But what's important for our discussion today is something called the COBRA subsidy. It is a provision where the federal government, in certain instances, will provide up to 65% of the cost, will pay 65% of the cost of continuing health benefits for a certain period of time. So that means that you would only pay 35% of the group health premiums. And this subsidy can last for up to 9 months, but it only applies if you are involuntarily terminated from employment. Now, that term, involuntary termination, is not defined, and is, but the interpretation that courts and agencies will give to it is very broad. So it could apply, for example, to a circumstance where you're employed under a contract for a certain period of time, even though the contract ends. If you are otherwise willing to continue working for that employer, you're still deemed to be involuntarily terminated. But in most instances, you're talking about a situation where an involuntary termination arises from a layoff. And if that happens, if you are working for an employer which is providing health benefits, then you will be eligible and you will be provided notice by the employer of your right to obtain this subsidy. Now, let me first explain COBRA, because this is a complicated situation where COBRA only applies if you're working for an employer with 20 or more employees. And if there's something called a qualifying event, which could be the death of an employee, a layoff, a divorce where the Spouse who's not the employee will not receive benefits. If you're a dependent on a group health plan and you reach the age where you're no longer qualify for benefits, these are all things called qualifying events. And so when there's a loss in coverage, you have a right under federal law, if you work for an employer with 20 or more employees, to continue benefits under COBRA. Now, COBRA is an acronym. It's the original name is the Comprehensive Omnibus Budget Reconciliation Act. It has nothing to do with healthcare. It was a budget resolution, and Congress tacked this on and snuck it in the bill, snuck it into the law, and it was passed. But everyone now refers to COBRA benefits as the right to continue healthcare benefits in certain circumstances. And normally, one can continue benefits, which you pay for up to 18 months. Now, there are certain situations where someone qualifies for disability, or there's a divorce while someone's receiving COBRA benefits, where those can be extended to 29 or 36 months. And that information should be provided to you by your employer after there's a qualifying event. Another qualifying event, which is something which is happening more and more often, is a reduction in hours. So you may be working for an employer as a full-time employee qualifying for group health benefits. Your hours are cut to a point where you no longer qualify for benefits. So you still would be employed, but there's been a reduction in hours which removes you from the group health plan. You still should get notice and the right to continue health benefits, even though you are still employed by that employer. Now, this gets confusing sometimes because I've talked about 9 months and I've talked about 18 months. The 9 months is the COBRA subsidy. The 18 months in most instances, if you work for an employer with 20 or more employees, is the time you're eligible to continue health benefits. So if there's a long period of unemployment, for the first 9 months, you may be eligible for the COBRA subsidy, where you're only paying 35%. But for the next 9 months, you would have to pick up the full amount of the health benefits if you want to continue them. Now, you don't have to make this decision up front. When you first get your notice, you'll get something generally in the mail. It's going to be a package. It's important that when you get this package, that you read it and open it. And it's complicated. But if you don't act, you will not get this subsidy. You will not be able to continue your group health benefits. And you have to act timely. So you will only have 60 days from the date that this letter is sent to you or this information is otherwise provided to you to elect. If you don't elect, if you don't send this back in, you will not get benefits, you will not get the subsidy. Now that gives you a time also to maybe consider whether you can do better somewhere else. Whether if you're young, if you are well, if you're male in some instances, you may be able to get cheaper coverage on your own. You want to compare that to explore whether that's available to you. But if you're eligible for the subsidy, it's unlikely that you're going to do better by getting an individual policy. So you certainly want to always look at eligibility for the continuation, the ability to continue health benefits. Now, there's someone called the plan administrator. And you should have received when you were getting group health benefits. Because this benefit is only available if you worked for an employer which provided group health benefits. If you worked for an employer that didn't have group health benefits, then turn the channel. If you, though, work for an employer with group health benefits, then you should be provided with this information by the plan administrator. And it, and because of this new law, in addition to providing you with information about COBRA, the package is going to explain this COBRA subsidy and indicate that you need to return other forms in order to qualify for the COBRA subsidy. Now, I've talked a lot about 20 or more employees, and that's the federal law. Well, the second law I want to talk about is a brand new law, which was just passed in Pennsylvania. And one of the reasons why the law was passed was to enable people to qualify for this subsidy. If you work for an employer with between 2 and 19 employees, and you've lost your group health coverage. You also, significantly, will be able to use this COBRA subsidy if you are involuntarily terminated from employment. So this extends the coverage to almost everybody who had group health coverage and lost it as a result of an involuntary termination. Now, I've also just talked about the employee. If your dependents, your spouse, your children were also on the group health plan, they also have the right to continue benefits. And you should have the right to what I'll call mix and match. So let's say all members of your family were covered and there's a qualifying event, such as a layoff, you should have the chance to say, I'm only going to cover myself, or only my spouse, or my spouse and family. You can pick and choose because maybe you want to eliminate some of your coverage. Maybe you don't want the vision plan or the dental plan, but keep your core medical benefits for financial reasons or because you have other coverage. So this extends to employees and dependents who lose their group health coverage. And if it's because of an involuntary termination, there's the ability to continue with this subsidy for up to 9 months. The COBRA subsidy is a limited subsidy in terms of it at this point in time, it applies to anyone who had an involuntary termination, who worked for an employer with 20 or more employees, who was involuntarily terminated between September 1, 2008 and December 31, 2009. And if you elect COBRA coverage and it's because of an involuntary termination and you otherwise qualify, you can get this 65% subsidy. Now, if you work for an employer with fewer than 20 employees, after July 9th, starting on July 10th, continuing through December 31, you are also eligible if there was an involuntary termination and you work for an employer who had group health coverage where the employer had between 2 and 19 employees. And the subsidy is provided in the case of COBRA, 20 or more employees, directly back to the employer. You don't have to worry about that. The employer will get a credit on their tax returns. The employer, though, is the one, or the plan administrator for the employer, is administering those benefits. Under mini COBRA, it's a little different because the entity administering the ability to continue health benefits is going to be the insurance company, not your employer. So if you work for an employer with fewer than 20 employees in Pennsylvania and you lose your group health benefits, you should be getting a notice from your employer saying you have the right to this subsidy. And you should contact this person at the health insurer in order to continue your benefits. The employer is also required to tell the insurance company that there has been a change in your status. Now, this is a brand new law. A lot of employers are not going to know about this. So you need to be attentive to to whether you may qualify and be in touch with your employer, the insurance carrier, to see if you qualify for this subsidy and can extend your benefits. Even if you're laid off or have some other qualifying event on December 31, 2009, you still will get the 9 months of coverage, the 9 months of COBRA subsidy. So that could last through September of 2010. But if at this point, unless Congress changes the law, if you're involuntarily terminated on January 1, 2010, while you still may qualify for COBRA or mini COBRA and be able to extend your benefits, there is no subsidy. So if it's getting late in the year and there may be a layoff, it's important that that happen on December 31, 2009, unless the law changes, as opposed to January 1, 2010, in order to qualify for the subsidy. So if you are otherwise eligible for group health coverage, you don't get the subsidy. So the most common situation is you're married, you have a spouse who's also working for an employer who has group health coverage, and you are able through your spouse to go on the spouse's health plan. If that is the case, then you are not eligible for the subsidy. Now that may not be fair because it may cost you a lot more money to go on your spouse's health plan, but that's the law. Also, if you are eligible for Medicare, then you are not eligible for COBRA benefits and you're not eligible for the subsidy. So if you're age 65 and over, or you otherwise qualify for Medicare, this is not going to apply to you. You are going to be on that other federal program and not be eligible for COBRA. There also is a significant situation, and this is a very challenging situation, where if you work for an employer that shuts down completely and they end all their group health coverage, in that very significant circumstance, there is no COBRA, and therefore there is not any COBRA subsidy. Now there may be situations where even if an employer shuts down, if they otherwise continue group health coverage, that you may be able to go on that plan. If there's some sort of merger that leads to the closure of the facility that you're working in, the buyer who takes over the company you were working for may still have an obligation to offer COBRA benefits to you. If you're an individual with an adjusted gross income of $125,000 or more, you are not eligible. There's a phase out of the subsidy, and after $145,000, you are not eligible for the subsidy. So you need to consider, if you have high income, whether you want to receive the COBRA subsidy. If you get it and you're not eligible, Uncle Sam is going to take it back from you. For a family situation, if you're a joint filer, the limits are $250,000 to $290,000. There's a phase out in that range, and over $290,000, you don't get the subsidy. Uncle Sam, Congress does not want to subsidize people who otherwise probably have the means to continue their health coverage. So if you have high income, you want to look at this issue, you want to talk to your tax advisor, and consider whether it makes any sense to get this income subsidy, get this COBRA subsidy. The premium reduction only lasts for 9 months. Now, if you're in Pennsylvania, group health coverage, working for an employer with fewer than 20 employees, that's the same length of time you have the right to continue group health coverage, 9 months, 9 months. If you work for an employer with 20 or more employees, your COBRA eligibility is longer, but you only will get the subsidy for up to 9 months. Now, if during the time you're receiving the COBRA subsidy, you become eligible for Medicare or eligible for another group health plan, then the subsidy is going to stop, and you have an obligation to tell your employer or the insurance company that you're no longer eligible for that COBRA subsidy or no longer eligible for COBRA benefits. The good thing about this is you don't have to front the money and pay 100% of the premium and then wait to get a check from the government. The government is requiring the employer or the insurance company to say to you that you only need to pay 35%, and they will provide the other 65% and then get that back from the government. Now, let me explain the math of this, because when you're in a group health plan, there's a certain level of premiums that are being paid. If you're on COBRA, meaning you work for an employer with 20 or more employees, the employer can tack on a 2% administrative fee. They're not required to do that, but they can do that, and most employers do. So the numbers you should be provided are 102% of what the group health coverage would be. And you take that 102% number, multiply it by 35%, and that's the amount you should be paying. If you work for an employer with 20 or more employees, you lose group health coverage and there's an involuntary termination. Now, for Pennsylvania employees who work for smaller employers with fewer than 20 employees, the insurance company sets the amount that's being paid, and it can be 105%, or a 5% fee can be put on top of that. And so you would take the 105%, multiply it by 35%, and that's the amount you would be paying for that 9 months of continuation coverage. Now, you don't have to do the math. The employer or the insurance company should provide you with this information, should provide you with your options, and should provide you with the monthly cost of this, because you don't have to upfront all the money for all the coverage. You don't know how circumstances may change, but you will need to remit or pay the premium, even at a 35% level if you qualify, each month. If you don't pay, then your benefits can be cut off. So it's important to continue to make these payments in a timely way in order to continue your health benefits. My health coverage was terminated when my employer shut down and laid off all its workers. Can I get the premium reduction to pay for new health coverage? If there's no longer a health plan, there is often no COBRA coverage available, unless there's another related or successor employer who sponsors a group plan responsible for providing continuation coverage to you. So that's the worst case scenario we have talked about. What can you do if your employer denies your application for a premium reduction? If the plan says to you that you are not eligible, you can request a review of that determination. Here's where it gets a little complicated. If you work for an employer with 20 or more employees, meaning you're under federal COBRA, then you would go to the United States Department of Labor. And they have an appeal form. It's available online. You can even submit it online if you have that capability. Or there are people, and I'll give you these phone numbers and websites, who can assist you with filing a review of that determination. If you work for a small Pennsylvania employer with fewer than 20 employees, then you would submit your appeal to the federal United States Department of Health and Human Services. And they also have a website, and they also have people who are going to assist you. Or if you work for the federal, state, or local government, the Department of Health and Human Services is the place to go to challenge any determination that you're not eligible for the subsidy. The government is required to make a determination within 15 business days after you submit an appeal. So it's very fast, much faster than many other governmental processes. We've talked about the mini COBRA law, and that's for employees with fewer than 20, that's for if you work for an employer with fewer than 20 employees, the administration of that law is going to be more messy because it's brand new. It was just passed in June 2009. It's going to affect July 10th. And so there's probably be less knowledge of how to apply that law. So in particular, if you work for a smaller employer, you want to be attentive about asserting your rights, getting the appropriate notification, so there's no loss in coverage and no gap in coverage. Now, we've talked about the COBRA subsidy being available through December 31, 2009. If there's an involuntary termination through December 31, 2009. For employees who work for a smaller employer, they're only eligible for the subsidy if they're laid off between July 10 and December 31, 2009. Now, starting January 1, 2010, there's still the ability to continue benefits. That does not end. The only thing that ends at that point is the COBRA subsidy. But if the economy is still in the shape it's in and that continues, there's certainly a possibility that the federal government will continue that. If your employer does not know about this mini COBRA law, then you should contact the Department of Health and Human Services. The way to secure information, there's a website, www.continuationcoverage.net. www.continuationcoverage.net. Also, the Pennsylvania Department of Insurance can assist you. Now, both of this website and this Pennsylvania Insurance Department contact information is only if you work for a governmental employer or you work for an employer with fewer than 20 employees. They have a toll-free number, the Pennsylvania Department of Insurance is 877-881-6388. If you work for an employer with 20 or more employees, then you want to contact the Federal Department of Labor. They have an excellent website, which should be able to answer most of your questions. The website address is www.dol for Department of Labor.gov, www.dol.gov/COBRA, COBRA. And they also have a phone number, toll-free, where you can contact people from the Department of Labor to assist you with applying for benefits. And their number is 866-444-3272. That's 866-444-3272. I hope you've enjoyed this program and received valuable information. It is important, even in an economically challenging time, to continue health benefits for yourself and your family.